Welcome. We are learning about Drupal coding standards and why it is important to use them. Before we start developing our first module, let's become familiar with Drupal coding standards. When we write code, we need to make sure that any developer can understand it easily at any time. That could be later today, tomorrow, or in the future when you have moved on to a different project. When you start sharing code, or you start reading code shared by others, you begin to realize that not everyone writes their code the way you do. Drupal coding standards are a collection of agreed-upon guidelines of the best practices to follow when writing code for a Drupal project. The code standards are a living document and are always current, meaning they reflect what active Drupal developers have decided as best practice. Coding standards say how we must write code so the project is developed in a consistent style and makes the code easier for everyone to understand, follow, and maintain. The main documentation source for Drupal coding standards is drupal.org/coding-standards. The standards are fairly comprehensive. Drupal leverages the technologies of PHP, Twig, Symfony, YAML, DocBlocks, and PSR4 namespaces, all of which have their own syntax requirements and guidelines. In this video, we'll examine some of the most common coding guidelines as they can get us up and running quickly. To begin, know that Drupal coding standards are version independent and always current. All new code should follow the current standards regardless of Drupal core version. However, it's nice to know that if you are working with old existing code, the existing code could be updated to conform to the new coding standards, but it doesn't have to. For naming conventions, it's important to remember that classes and interfaces always use upper camel casing. Methods and class properties should be consistent in using either lower camel naming or snake case using underscores. Strive not to mix lower camel or snake case naming. Be consistent with the approach that you use. Another overarching guideline is that when you type comments or name code elements such as methods, functions, constants, or classes, the US English spelling should be used. For example, the word color should be spelled as C-O-L-O-R and not C-O-L-O-U-R. Let's learn about file structure and naming. Each class must be in its own file within the SRC folder. This is due to the PSR4 namespacing and autoloading in Drupal. Recall that you have encountered a specific instance of this already when we learned about plugins. You'll also experience placing classes in SRC in our first module. The file should be named after its class. So, for example, the popular token module has token.php, complete with capitalization, capital T. There should always be just one class or one interface or one trait per file. Two words to avoid in naming are Drupal and class. Make sure not to use the word Drupal or class in the class name. However, interfaces should end with interface.php, as should test class names always end in test.php. We'll do some of those as we go. For modules which create classes, the module's code should be placed inside a custom namespace. The convention for those namespaces begins as Drupal /module name. So, for example, let's say the name of your module is Opportunity, and it has a class of Open Door. The class Drupal /opportunity/open door is in the namespace of Drupal /opportunity, and it should be in a file named opendoor.php with the full file path of opportunity/src/opendoor.php. As mentioned earlier, class and interface naming should use upper camel. Within those classes, use lower camel or snake case for methods and attributes. These PHP code standards in Drupal have been around for a long time. It is important that we indent with exactly 2 spaces. Do not use tabs. Each line of Drupal code should have no trailing white space and should be no longer than 80 characters. Now, clearly, use your reasonable judgment here. If there's a long function name or various definitions or declarations, you're obviously going to need more than 80 characters. But always strive to use no more than 80 characters. Files should use the Unix line endings, not the Windows line endings, and files should end in a single new line. Also, it's important to remember that PHP files should begin with the full PHP tag. And for PHP files in Drupal, there should not be a closing PHP tag at the end of the file. Operators that come between 2 values, called binary operators, such as plus or minus, should have a space on either side. Operators that operate on only 1 value, such as plus plus, known as unary operators, should not have a space between the operator and the number or variable they affect. Use else if, one word, not else space if, when that type of control structure is needed. And be sure to include a space between the control keyword and the opening parentheses. Always use curly braces for control structures, even in situations where they're optional. PHP arrays should be formatted using short array syntax. Short array syntax is just the square brackets. Within the brackets, a space should separate each element after the comma. There should also be spaces around the key association operator if applicable. Of course, in many cases, the line declaring an array will span longer than 80 characters. This is often the case with form and menu declarations. In these situations, each array element should be broken into its own line and indented one level. Make note of the comma that is placed at the end of the last array element. This is not a typo. It helps prevent parsing errors if another element is placed at the end of the list later. YAML is a human-friendly data serialization standard for all programming languages. A superpower of YAML is in its compatibility with JSON. Both JSON and YAML aim to be human-readable data interchange formats. However, JSON and YAML do have different priorities. JSON's foremost design goal is simplicity and universality. Thus, JSON is trivial to generate and parse at the cost of reduced human readability. In contrast, YAML's foremost design goals are human readability and support for serializing arbitrary native data structures. As such, YAML allows for extremely readable files, but is more complex to generate and parse. In practice, YAML can be viewed as a natural superset of JSON. Every JSON file is also a valid YAML file. This makes it easy to migrate from JSON to YAML if or when required. Now, with YAML file syntax, correct whitespace is critical. We use spacing and indentation to indicate how certain elements are related to one another. When indenting, use 2 spaces for indentation levels. Don't use tabs. Some editors, such as Notepad++, will use tabs by default. Make sure you correct that. Congratulations on getting familiar with Drupal coding standards. Remember, Drupal coding standards are a collection of agreed-upon guidelines of the best practices to follow when writing code for a Drupal project. You may not be the last person that works on that code. The key takeaways are: use upper camel naming for classes and interfaces. You can use either lower camel or snake case for method and variable names, but pick one style and be consistent with it. Always use the short array syntax for arrays in PHP. Strive to keep each line less than 80 characters. You can do it. And always, always use 2 spaces. Never use tabs. There really is a lot to learn with regards to coding standards. Please review the links provided shortly to get a broader overview of everything that is involved. Of course, these are guidelines, and we'll learn more as appropriate as we get more experience. So that's all for now. Happy learning!
you.